Hello everybody, this is Manuel. Welcome to another Eternal news video here on EternalTitans.com. So the news are coming in fast and hard. First, we had the announcement of the 2019 Eternal World Championships and how to qualify for it. And then we had today's topic, the first spoiler for the upcoming micro-campaign from LSV's stream last night. So let's take a look. So now, after we had a bunch of small scions, like Caleb, for example, or sort of small scions like Talia, it's time for a second Vara. This one is really cool and also really powerful, if you ask me. First of all, we get a 3-4 lifesteal for 4 power. Double shadow, so she's not splashable. And on summon, the enemy player must choose to sacrifice a unit or give Vara +2/+2 and deadly. The wording is a bit suboptimal, if you ask me, because the card does not work like Warprex. The opponent has to do one or the other. So if they can't sacrifice a unit, Vara becomes a 5/6 lifesteal deadly. Unlike with Warprex, where you just can choose the thing. You don't even have, like, you can't choose to sacrifice a unit here if you don't have a unit. I wish it would say, it would be clearer that if they can't sacrifice a unit, that she gets +2/+2 and deadly. But not sure what the best way would be, the best way to word it that way, and also might get too wordy. So yeah, keep that in mind. Makes her a lot better. So she's either basically a 3-4 lifesteal with an edict. For anyone that doesn't know where the phrase is coming from, it's coming from magic and refers to something that makes the opponent sacrifice a unit opposed to targeted removal killing a unit. And the first card in magic that did that was called Diabolic Edict, I think. And that's where the name is coming from. And a lot of later versions had the word edict in their name or were still referred to as edicts. Anyway, I'm getting off track. This card's really great. The most important or most interesting part is in the middle between the lifesteal and the summon. It's nothing can have Aegis. This works the following way. When she comes into play, everything that has an Aegis loses the Aegis. They still keep the keyword, but the Aegis basically gets popped. And after that, nothing can gain an Aegis. I think they can still get the keyword Aegis. Like if you give something Aegis, they will get the keyword, but not the Aegis. But I'm not 100% sure. It's even possible that while Vara is out, that they don't even get the keyword. I'm not 100% sure on that. If anyone has specific information on that, please let me know in the comments down below. Either way, there won't be Aegises in play, neither on players nor on units. So this is a pretty powerful tool, and people have been complaining about the strength of Aegis, and this is a nice tool to fight that, and a very good mid-range and control 4-drop. This, for example, pairs really well with factions that have good removal, like for example in Argentport colors, be it straight up Argentport or four factions, or like three faction decks, for example. Playing a turn 4 Vara makes sure that your follow-up harsh rule, for example, is guaranteed to wipe the board and not even stoppable by, say, Stand Together, which is really powerful. There are a lot of good Aegis effects. There's Stand Together, there's sort of Unity. There are good Aegis units like Groundwatch Paladin, Shelterwing Rider, Kozul Battlemage, Champion of Cunning, Ikaria. So there's a lot of good Aegis stuff going on. Vadius, Snowcrust Yeti, Yennef Merchant. So there's a lot of good Aegis around. That this fights really well. And 4 health also means that she blocks pretty well. She blocks all the smaller units, most 1 to 3 cost units. Lifesteal is also very good in mid-range and control decks to stabilize or catch back up. So that's pretty great. She obviously leaves the opponent some choice, like for example, they can just make her a 5-6 and then permafrost her or vanquish her or equivocate her or whatever. So the summon effect isn't that strong, but plus there are decks that just have a bunch of throwaway units, but she's really in it for like being a card that cannot be ignored, providing lifesteal even if you buff her otherwise, and just mainly the Aegis suppression. And imagine in like Argent Port colors you also have cards like Vanquish and Slay and Annihilate. So great removal, and often these Aegises are a big problem. Unless you basically have Varus Favor or have the power to, say, use an Enforcer and your removal to get rid of the unit right away. Also, there's a Feast Caller, another one that I forgot. So yeah, this provides a lot of tools to fight this. Pairs really well with spot removal and even Harsh Rule and some other things. Also makes stuff that targets the player a lot better, because Face Eaters can be an even bigger problem, because Enforcer doesn't help there, only Varus Favor does. So Vara is a clean way to get rid of these Face Eaters and also make sure they don't set it back up, like they basically need to kill Vara and have another Face Eaters. And this helps set up stuff like Ezindel's Gift, Sabotage, that sort of stuff. So yeah, the card is really cool, it's a very unique effect and tool. Nice stats, nice utility, just an overall great card. I'm super excited for her, and I'm looking forward to what else we're gonna get. This is definitely a card that is gonna significantly change the metagame. Like, imagine Shelterwing Rider alone, like this just completely shuts down Shelterwing Riders, which is a really big deal, with TJP being one of the top decks again, for example. So yeah, amazing card, also looks really good, cool artwork, and yeah, excited to see what else the campaign has in store for Constructed. If the campaign is at all at a similar level as Dead Reckoning was, I'm super excited and happy, because Dead Reckoning had a lot of cool and great Constructed relevant cards that shook up the metagame nicely. Dead Reckoning, I think, was easily the best campaign so far, and if they continue at that level of quality and impact, there's no reason not to be excited for the next micro campaign. They can easily have close to as much impact as some of the sets, because the percentage of quality high impact cards is significantly higher with the small card pool. All right, that's it again for today. Vara Vengeance Seeker coming soon. Let's hope the campaign comes sometime next month. I could see maybe at the end of next month, for example, or even a bit earlier. Not sure, maybe at the, in the middle, because we barely have the middle of September and the spoiler season is starting. So normally the spoiler season takes like 3 or 4 weeks or something. So yeah, we could see this mid-October, which would be very reasonable, because I would assume this, the campaign to be legal for the first ECQs, the Eternal Championship qualifiers. So they want to release this stuff early enough so that we have time to test and the metagame to shake things out a bit. So with the first ECQ being in early November, I would assume late October would be too late for the campaign. So actually, my guess would be like mid-October probably, so that we at least have 2, 3, 4 weeks for things to settle down a bit and test for the first tournament. But we'll see. All right, that's it again for today. That's my take on Vara Vengeance Seeker. I'm Manuel. This was Eternal News with the first spoiler for the new campaign, which we don't even have a name for yet, as far as I know. And I thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye.